Simmons knocks it down, but couldn't do anything with it. McKinnon has it. Playing it down to the center, and it goes on through. And stumbling and unable to get to it was Couturier. Now it's Barry. To Mitchell. Mitchell wrist shot deflects through. Pass Giroux. McKinnon turnaround shot. Zay Mason. O'Reilly centers it. Loose pass. Mitchell shot is blocked. 2 seconds. One. Murray cannot get it in front. The game is over. The Flyers hold on and edge the Colorado Avalanche 4-3 as they are now 3-3.
All right. Well, it's game day for Week 10. The Eagles taking on the Carolina Panthers at Lincoln Financial Field, Monday Night Football. Second time they've been on Monday night this year. They're 1-0 on Monday night. They won at Indianapolis in Week 2, and now they're playing, of course, Week 10 home against the Panthers. The final game of Week 10, and the Eagles hope to, you know, get the 7-2 on the season with a win. The Panthers come in 3-5-1 and have been very Jekyll and Hyde this season. They've struggled on defense, which was one of their strengths a year ago. I know one of their key defensive players is out with suspension, but still, they've really struggled, particularly against the run. And one of the Eagles' strengths, in recent weeks anyhow, has certainly been running, has been the run. Mark Sanchez makes his first start as an Eagles quarterback, of course, with Nick Foles being out. And, hopefully the Eagles, like I said in the last video, are the three-headed monster of Shady, McCoy, Darren Sproles, and Chris Polk can get it done again this week. The Panthers have been run on like a floor mat. I mean, every team seems to just be able to run at will against their defense, and hopefully it will be the same tonight with the Eagles. I think the Eagles are going to have a good, strong run game, because even though Sanchez had a decent game in relief of Foles last week, now obviously there's a whole week of preparation against him, and having that running game for any quarterback is a good thing. It certainly helps out any quarterback and the offense. So I think the Eagles will certainly run the ball pretty well. And I know the Panthers still have some weapons on defense. I mean, Luke Kuechly is still one of the best linebackers in the game. Facebook messages. But anyhow, there's there's still some players there to make some plays on that defense, but you can still have success against them. A lot of teams have had success against that defense this year, and the Eagles are undefeated at home. So they'll be coming home for the first time since just before the bye week, when they shut out the Giants 27-0. Then, of course, they lost at Arizona and after the bye week, and then won 31-21 against the Texans in Houston last week. So the Eagles coming off a win, and as far as my prediction for the game, I do believe that the loss of D'Amico Ryans is going to be a big injury for the Eagles on defense. And that being said, you know, Cam Newton, even though that Carolina offense hasn't been that great this season, you still got to worry about Cam Newton. He's a dual threat quarterback. He can pass, he can run, and he's played pretty good against the Eagles over the years when the Eagles have faced him. But I do believe that as far as the team that has the most more weapons on offense is the Eagles. And that being said, with the fact that they're home for the first time since that shutout win against the Giants, I know the fans are going to be pumped up. I know all the local fans and non-local fans that will be there. I know E-Rock will be there. And, season ticket holders and all the rest there made some big noise so far this season. The Eagles have had one of the best home fans home field advantages, I should say, in the league, I think, this season. I mean, it shows they're undefeated at home so far. The fans have made a lot of noise. You know they're going to be there strong tonight and, making their voices heard. I think the Eagles will win. I do think the game will be dictated as far as how well the Eagles offense can move the ball. And like I said, the Eagles running attack should have a lot of success against the Panthers defense, and that should open things up in the passing game. I'm predicting the Eagles to win pretty handily. I think they're going to win by at least 16 points. That's my prediction. That's what I predicted here at work, so I got to stick with it. I do believe the Eagles are the better team. Now, the better team doesn't always win. I understand that, but I do believe they're the better team in this game with the home fans, the fact that they are undefeated at home so far this season, the fact that they've played really well at home. you know, particularly in the more recent games at home, I know they struggled a bit versus Jacksonville the beginning of that game, the home opener. But they played overall pretty good at home, and I do believe that the Eagles version of the 12th man will certainly be there for them tonight, and you know, cheering like Eagle fans do every week. And you know, so I do believe that factored in with the fact that the Eagles running offense has had some success in recent weeks, certainly since they started getting guys back on the offensive line. They also get Mathis back today, got really good guard off the injured list, so you know, that's a big piece back on the offensive line. They're going to be without Harriman's the rest of the year, but they get Mathis back, they got Kelsey back last week, and that really helps open things up for the running game. Like I said, now they have that three-headed monster in there, and you know, so I think that bodes really well against the Panthers defense. Like I said, not very good against the run. All that being said, like I said, that's one of the reasons why I think the Eagles are going to have a really good game offensively. I think they'll take care of business, and I think they win by at least 16 points. That's just my prediction. I could be wrong, but that's how I see this game going down. And I guess the next you'll see me will be at home with some post-game reaction, and try to see if I can fit in some highlights of the game too. So as always, go Birds. Let's go Eagles. Let's get this win tonight on Monday Night Football, Week 10, against those Carolina Panthers. All right, everyone. Till the next segment. Well, you'll be seeing the next segment next, so. But I gotta say that every time for some reason. All right, go Birds. All right, well, at halftime, the Eagles are winning 31-7 over the Panthers. They have four defensive turnovers in the game. The defense has played great. Special teams, Darren Sproles with a punt return for touchdown. He also has a rushing touchdown. Mark Sanchez has looked pretty good. He has a touchdown pass in the game so far to Jordan Matthews, and the Eagles are on top once again, 31-7. And I just wanted to, you know, say this little thing at halftime. I would be remiss with tomorrow being Veterans Day to say thank you. And I'm wearing the fatigue hat here, the Eagles fatigue hat, for the supporting the troops. And, you know, thank you to all the brave men and women out there protecting the country. And, you know, thank you and a salute to you, brave men and women. Thank you for all you do, of course. And of course, those who served. Those who are continuing to serve, and to all of our veterans out there, again, thank you very much, and it's greatly appreciated all that all of you have done, and for those who continue to serve, what you continue to do. But anyhow, the Eagles, again, up 31-7, looks like my double-digit victory prediction is looking pretty good so far. Still got half to go, but the Eagles are playing great right now. Again, with a 31-7 big win at home, and big lead at home, I should say. Hopefully will be a win. And as I said earlier, the Eagles have yet to lose at home so far this season, so it's looking good that they'll keep that going. And we'll see what happens in the second half. I'll be back after the game with a little post-game analysis. And as always, go Birds. Looking good so far. Well, the Eagles took care of business on Monday night. They crushed the Carolina Panthers 45-21 on Monday Night Football. And they are 2-0 on Monday Night Football. So So that song's been very good to them this year. And really, all around, great win for the Eagles. Now, I did say before the game that the Panthers stink against the run, and they made it they were tired of hearing that all season long. So they made a point to leave 8 and 9 in the box to try to stop the run, and they were pretty effective with that. It's basically the only thing they did well all game long. LeSean McCoy only had about 19 yards of rushing. One touchdown, though. Sproles had a rushing touchdown as well. You saw that in a little highlight package from Eagles.com, actually. So shout out to Eagles.com. Really good site. All Eagle fans, I'm sure, know about it. Watch the videos and all. Really great source of for everything Eagles. So, but yes, the Eagles didn't really have a great running game, but that's okay because Chip Kelly's like, well, okay, you guys leave that many in the box, we're just going to go over the top then. And they basically were able to have their way in the passing game. And Mark Sanchez had a really good game, 2 touchdowns, no interceptions, almost had an interception, but the defender caught it out of bounds. His foot was just out of bounds, but didn't count. As I said, not a lot of things went right for the Panthers on Monday night, but yeah, the Eagles had a lot of success in the passing game, particularly in particular, Brent Celek, over 100 yards receiving, and Jordan Matthews, another big game for him. And it seems like he and Sanchez are on a pretty good rapport so far through 2 games now that Sanchez, well, 1.5 really games, or 1.75, I should say, games where Sanchez has been the starter. He's connected with Matthews for 3 touchdowns, including 2 on Monday night, and the rookie is really coming along here and playing really well. He had over 100 yards receiving, I think about 8 catches. One of his best games, certainly his best game since the Washington game earlier in the year when he had I believe 2 touchdowns in that game too. And he was one of the primary targets. Now, the Panthers tried to take Jeremy Maclin away, and they really, you know, had a lot of coverage on him, a lot of attention on him, and rightfully so. He was the Eagles' leading receiver for the past few weeks. So, okay, you're gonna play that game. Well, there's Jordan Matthews. There's Brent Celek. You know, they haven't really gotten Zach Ertz into the offense too much, but Celek certainly had a big game. Riley Cooper, I think he had like a catch or two. He's been very disappointing this season. But that being said, you know, a really nice game all around for the offense. In the passing game, Sanchez had a really nice game. The thing about Sanchez that we see that's different from Foles, and yes, Sanchez has been a starting quarterback in the league much longer than Foles, but his pocket awareness and the fact that he moves around in the pocket, uses his feet, can feel the rush coming, gets away, avoids the rush, steps up instead of going backwards to make the throw. Now, again, Nick Foles is a young quarterback. There's things he needs to learn. And I'm not saying that Sanchez is the next coming of you know, Peyton Manning or anything like that, but certainly in a game in 3 quarters, he's played really well. And you know, he had a couple of interceptions there against the Texans. Not all of his fault, but no interceptions in this game. Looked really sharp. Had a long drive after the Panthers early in the game. It was a 10-7 Eagles lead. Eagles were pinned back, and Sanchez drove them down the field for a touchdown. And that really, I mean, you know, that pretty much was like the Eagles saying, okay, well, you know, not going to happen tonight, Carolina. Sanchez had a really nice game, all things being said. The fact that, you know, the Panthers really defended, tried to stop the run for the first time all year, really. And, you know, tried to make the Eagles one-dimensional, and that one dimension certainly worked. Defensively, great, another great game for the Eagles defense. They swarming around Cam Newton, and I know Cam Newton looked a little hobbled there, but you know, they were able to rush him, hit him, sack him. He just was really unaffected for most of the game until the very end, when really the game was out of reach. I mean, the Panthers scored a couple touchdowns there. Game was kind of out of reach at that time, though. But really, the whole rest of the game it was you know, shutdown mode for the Eagles defense. They played really well. They stopped the run. They've done a great job against the run all year. They really, you know, got the Cam Newton. You know, it was also the first full game without D'Amico Ryans. And, you know, of course, he's the, you know, the quarterback of the defense, starting middle linebacker. And in his place was
was Casey Matthews, who's nowhere near like his brother Clay, who we'll be seeing this week. With the Packers, he had a nice game too. You know, you gotta give credit when credit's due, and I know Casey gets a lot of heat around here, but he had a nice game. The defense had a really nice game, good game plan going in. Really just, you know, harassed Cam Newton the whole game and made life miserable for him in his stay at Philly this time. So great game. Special teams, obviously, another great game on the kickoffs, on the punts. And, of course, Darren Sproles had a return for touchdown, and the Panthers, you know, for whatever reason, wanted to kick him the ball middle of the field. But that's okay. Thank you, Carolina, and Sproles certainly thanks you, too. And he took it back to the house. He's been an absolute amazing player, pickup, I should say, from the Saints this offseason. Him and Jenkins have been just tremendous. The two cast-offs from New Orleans have been really, really good for the Eagles, and they even made a comment, I think it was Gruden that made the comment during the game, that for the first time since Brian Dawkins, the Eagles have a solid safety in Jenkins, who has. He's been a great, great addition for this team, and for the first time, really, I can attest to that, for the first time since Dawkins, they have a solid safety, which is always a good thing to have on a defense. One of the reasons their defense has played pretty good this year. And their quarterbacks, Williams and Fletcher, had their first interceptions of the season. It took them all the way until week 9 to get them, but week 10, no. I'm a little out of it. Getting the weeks confused. So the Eagles are 7-2. They had the bye week, so that's 8. So that's week... Week 10. There it is. I'm forgetting what week this is. I'm like trying to, you know, remember, okay, well, this is for the Panther game and not the Packer game, you know, because I make these videos during the week. But I had a little brain freeze there. I apologize about that. Week 10. It took them all the way up until week 10, until their ninth game, because they had the bye week. Week 10. They get their first interceptions for the cornerbacks all season. So it's been a while, but better late than never, right? Maybe that starts something. Now, obviously, this week they play, you know, Aaron Rodgers and the Packers, a whole different animal there in Green Bay. And we'll get into that game as week 11 comes up, as the video for week 11 gets started. But, again, great win for the Eagles. They're 7-2 going into that big game at Green Bay, the primetime, probably game of the week game. 4 o'clock start Eastern time, so should be a great game, but great win, great last two wins after that tough loss to the Cardinals. The Eagles have certainly done a great job, and they're still undefeated at home, Seattle. There's one of us is undefeated at home. It's the Eagles. But anyhow, home field advantage is certainly important. The Eagles have played great at home, and hopefully they can continue with on the home winning ways in a couple weeks against Tennessee. But nonetheless, terrific game, great game. Another one of those games get just kind of relax at halftime, not have to worry too much about it. Second half, and all around a great game. Great game call by Chip Kelly, kind of adjusting to what the Panthers are doing defensively, you know, the passing, the middle of the field was open for the pass, and that's exactly what they do. That's called adjusting, something that the previous coach we always harped on for not being able to do, and Andy Reid. But those days are then, now it's now, certainly a great win overall. Certainly want to see the running game get going again. The Packers, again, one of those teams that you know, are not that solid against the run defensively, but we said that about Carolina. So we'll see what happens. This is the only kind of negative from this game, is that the Eagles' running game really wasn't able to go. But then again, the Panthers, really, their game plan was to stop the run and key in on the run. They've had trouble with it this season, but they really wanted to focus on that this year, because the Eagles, against the Texans, you know, were able to have some, you know, a lot of production running the ball. And also they figured, you know, with Sanchez in there for the first time. Oh, goodness. Oh. This is popped up on the screen. With Sanchez in there making his first start, you know, let's see, you know, let's try to, you know, make him, you know, beat us. And, well, that's what happened. So, Carolina, yeah, I guess that didn't work out too well. And then Sanchez, after the game, goes and eats some cheesesteaks. So, you know, saying hello to the fans there. But, again, great win for the Eagles. They're 7-2, as I said. Next up, it's at Green Bay on Sunday. Sunday at late afternoon, about 4 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Start kickoff. And, yeah, Eagles win. It was a great win. As you saw at the beginning of the video, it was a pretty good weekend, you know, for me, sports-wise here. My buddy Mark and I, Mark M., of course, shout out to him. We were at the Flyers game Saturday night. We got on TV at the end of the game after the win, 4-3. And then the Eagles win on Monday night. So a great couple days there, you know, kind of weekend plus Monday, sports-wise for this past weekend. And we'll see what this coming weekend brings. So, as always, go Birds! And big game coming up at Lambeau against the Cheeseheads. And we'll see what happens then. And sorry I'm a little lackadaisical today. Just, you know, it's a Wednesday. I had a long day at work, so... I'm just kind of getting back to, you know, normalcy here. But anyhow, great win by the Eagles on Monday night. And we'll see what happens. And going into Week 11 against the Packers. And as always, I'll have that next video for you out after the game sometime next week. And so that's going to do it for Week 10. As always, like I said, go Eagles! And I will see you in Week 11.